In a desert in northwest China, Cao Liao Han and his colleagues stop their jeep abruptly and jump out. They've spotted something ahead. It may be one of the elusive Bactrian camels they've been tracking for more than a week. The Annamba Bactrian Camel Reserve is in Gansu Province, on the north side of the Altun Mountains. Throughout their natural habitat in Central Asia, there are less than 1,000 Bactrian camels. More than half live on this reserve. They approach the spot carefully. Sharp eyesight and an acute sense of smell allow Bactrian camels to detect threats from far away. Tracking them is a difficult task for the reserve staff. Tao and his colleagues are downwind, but luck is not on their side. Nature, in fact, plays a trick on them. Camels can go without water for a long time, but it is still essential for them. Tao has a plan to bring water down from the snow-capped mountains. He's checking and measuring the proposed route. Tapping into the abundant supply of meltwater, they will build a man-made oasis. Tao wants to find a way to take water from the largest river in the reserve to create another watering hole deeper in the desert. Unfortunately, the project is too big to undertake at this time. An isolated farm is close to the reserve's border. The Bactrian camels often appear nearby. Tao is trying to learn more about the Bactrian camels. In winter, there is less rainfall here. People can tolerate a lack of water, but lambs may become sick. It's also time for the Bactrian camels to give birth. Tao is told there was a herd of camels nearby recently, and one of them is pregnant. Hairati isn't normally involved in field operations due to his age, but he's worked at the reserve for nearly 10 years and has never photographed a Bactrian camel calf. Spring arrives, and the pregnant Bactrian camel should have given birth. Tao decides to search for the herd as he checks on the water supply. He hopes to determine whether the calf was born. His daughter, however, is unhappy that her middle-aged father goes out into the desert on such expeditions. The reserve workers have plenty of experience. Though he is young, Kuli has a great deal of knowledge about Bactrian camels. The man-made oasis for the Bactrian camels is isolated. It takes a day to reach it from the reserve administration office. The pipe brings water down from the mountain. Tao needs to do some maintenance.
Okay. 音乐喷泉，弹到结束，当当当当
当当，好了。
The area is too harsh for humans, and Tao's hopes are raising upon seeing the broken water pipeline because it means the camels might be close. Hairati isn't interested in the repair work. He gets excited, though, at the sight of camel fur. It's proof they've been in the area. He joins the others to tear the pipe. Only when it's fixed can they resume the search for camels, and he can photograph them. After the pipe is repaired, Hairati urges them to get moving again. Ayubadi finds Bactrian camel urine, more evidence the camels may be close by.
This is 骆驼尿画的，
公的母的，
好像是母的，
你怎么感觉出来的？
难说，不过我觉得母骆驼是不是在后嘛，公骆驼在前面嘛，它尿管公骆驼可能在前面先。
你怎么觉得它靠后了？
通过这个尿液看嘛。
那公的到哪应该在哪儿啊？
应该是前面那个部位。
哪个地方？
应该在这儿。
母的在那个地方
啊。
哦。
反正也难说。
这里面一些汤姆。
还有多少缝？
这是我还要把它清理一下。
Bactrian camels need clean water. Due to sandstorms in the desert, the watering hole needs regular cleaning. It's also the best place to observe wild Bactrian camels. The team members set up infrared cameras. Silent and unobtrusive, they can photograph the camels at close range. Tao used to wait for hours in a pit. Now, with fully charged batteries and an empty digital storage card, capturing images of the camels is possible in all weather. Studying the images, the reserve workers can estimate the number of Bactrian camels and see how they live and reproduce.
Kali.
Huh?
Kali Mingbu.
Through long-term observation with infrared cameras, they observe a few wolves near the watering hole. But due to the low Bactrian camel population, they are rarely seen in the area. Although they don't see any adult Bactrian camels, they do find some calves in the images. It's a pleasant surprise.
跟随美的图案接着玛纳色滚的热那巴拉色爱和大声
鸡油全部都不了
啊
鸡油不了不得不得
鸡油太多了
对
鸡油加真的都放掉了
放掉出去那
After driving for half a day, they reach the closest reserve station. It's equipped with a generator and a satellite phone. Unfortunately, the generator is broken. Hirati is anxious. Without power to charge batteries, his camera won't work. It's an opportunity for Kohli.
Sonunda üst üste itibar etken de bunu hatırlıyorum.
Lamps and phones were once unavailable to the reserve workers. The following day, Tao and the others go to seek information from local herders.The winter has been cold and dry, and spring is late. Herders feel uneasy over the lack of rainfall. Tao feels uneasy as he becomes aware of how grave the situation is.He's afraid the water for the camels is too little. At night, they find traces of the camels. The camels must be moved to the watering hole without disturbing them. Tao decides to follow them and wait for an opportunity. They have to camp in the desert.It's a decision made on the spur of the moment, and they're not carrying enough equipment. They only have a small tent. Kohli and Ayibadi ask to stay in the jeep as they're younger and allow Tao and Hirati to sleep in the tent. It's late, and the temperature drops fast after the sun sets in the desert.They build a fire. They doubt they will find the Bactrian camels the next day. That night will prove to be lucky for Tao and his colleagues. A herd of Bactrian camels pass nearby.Tao and the others watch them silently as they move along. The next day brings an even greater surprise. At the foot of a sand dune, they find a young Bactrian camel. It was born a week earlier and cannot survive on its own. The calf cannot climb over the hill. Tao contacts the closest reserve station. He needs more people to control the calf. Bactrian camels seldom drop out of the herd. The others might have rushed for the water, leaving the calf behind. Perhaps they were frightened by water. Hirati calls the surrounding villages for help, but in the desert, they can't always make a connection.
啊，路上就是两份野辣子炒糕，还有什么牛奶、奶皮。啊？你先啊！啊，其实加个班呢，帮帮忙的。喂，哎，主任。
喂。
ben hasta bulmak değil de kol bitmiş sizler mi çıktı?
Oo, ne ne ne. O da beni özüm bırak.
Sizler mi çıktı?
Bu da arka bir değil mi? Tapsırsa üstü. Çarvası köbet bana da.
Ne?
Kendine yetiyor. O su da bile mi çıkıyor?
Hayır kardeşim.
Senin kızın var mı bir?
Var var.
Kaldırıp
dur. Al, otur. Burada vurmuyor.
Vurmuyor mi? Evet. Hey. Aa, ne kadar. Hey, biz de bu yerde bir tobacco bottle'ın bir yerde biz de bir yerde 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 哎呀，你这个想个办法嘛你，想个办法你把那些准备一下，要不然这个一个是这个骆驼也喝，坑也特别喝，有的有客，装备有两个外面啊，什么装修这？哎呀，你得想个办法。
The calls go through, but no one offers help. Irati gets upset. The others leave to ask for milk from nearby herders. Irati waits with the camel calf. A few hours later, the calf is brought to the reserve. The fresh cow milk is waiting for it. To obtain camel milk, Tao Liao Han visits a friend. The man is a herder. On the way, Tao prepares his arguments. Unfortunately, his friend has already let his camels go. Tao feels he is reluctant to help. A camel can sell for 10,000 yuan. A lactating camel is more expensive. It seems no one wants to provide help for free. Tao tries to reason with his friend. The Bactrian camels are simply too rare to lose this opportunity. He won't let the calf rescued in the desert die of hunger. Tao's friend finally promises to lend him a lactating camel. He must now get it back by himself. It takes half a day to drive to the administration office, but Tao has to lead the camels there on foot. Kuli may know how to climb mountains and fix equipment, but he's never herded camels. The calf finally has camel milk, but Tao's work is not finished. Before he retires, he plans to build a third place for the camels to get water. After rescuing the baby camel, Kelly returns to conservation work. He's waiting for his colleagues. Hairati has bought a new lens. With more places for the camels to go for water, he may be able to take more pictures of them. The baby camel is growing, and soon it will be returned to the wild. In the desert, Tao Liao Han and the others continue their work. Nanka and his family are helping preserve Przewalski gazelles. Nanka struggles to deal with the problems threatening these rare animals. Nanka is living his dream, but the job of saving the Przewalski gazelle is not an easy one. Please join us for part 4 of Nature Wars.